Greetings. More reasons to reject Islam. Reason number 4, the Quran is entirely hearsay. Really? Oh yeah. Once you stop and actually spend the time to know the definition of hearsay, you'll wonder why on earth does anyone give the Quran 10 seconds of time? Better yet, die for it, let alone murder for it. So here we go. What is the actual definition of hearsay? From the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Number 1. Rumor. Talk or opinion widely disseminated with no discernible source. Number 2. Also rumor. A statement or report without known authority for its truth. And third, probably the one you're most familiar with, hearsay evidence. Evidence based not on a witness's personal knowledge, but on another's statement not made under oath. Now from the Duhaime.org legal site, hearsay, evidence that is offered by a witness of which they do not have direct knowledge, but rather their testimony is based on what others have said. From the Free Dictionary Online, hearsay, unverified information heard or received from another. Number 2, hearsay, heard through another rather than directly. Hearsay is when you say something you heard someone else tell you. I think you are beginning to get the definition of hearsay. When you hear someone tell you something they themselves did not witness, that is hearsay. Remember that because it is worth repeating. When you hear someone tell you something they themselves did not witness, that is hearsay. If they heard the claim from someone else and did not witness it themselves, it is hearsay. Now that you have a solid understanding of what hearsay is, it is time you understand the story of Islam, to hear the ever-shifting tale of Mohammed's Quran. But first, there is something you should know. Islam is not concerned with facts or logic. Them's pretty bold words, Texas. Yes, they are bold words, because the truth is bold and fears nothing. Islam tells the story of Islam as fact. But when questioned, the facts change. Even so, the tale of Islam tries to stand on one fact. The Quran is the unquestionable word of Allah. And how do we know this fact? Muhammad told us. And how did Muhammad learn this fact? Muhammad said he heard it. And who did Muhammad say he heard it from? Muhammad said he heard it from a spirit calling itself Jibril. And where did Jibril say he got these messages combined into the Quran? Jibril is reported to have told Muhammad that Jibril heard Allah. Well, Islam is rarely ever so bold as to try and fill in such details. Islam generally stops with the claim, the Quran is the word of Allah, which Islam claims to mean that Allah is supposed to have spoken the Quran word for word in order in its entirety. And somehow, we know not and no one witnessed, Allah's words were written down into a book. Really? A whole book? Yep. According to Islam's mythology, Allah gave Jibril the whole Quran and told him to go and read it to Muhammad. So when Jibril came, he started to read at the first surah and ayat, right? Not actually. Instead, the very first revelation, which Muhammad claimed to have received, is now recorded as Surah 91:1. And here is why the Quran is hearsay. Remember, hearsay is when someone tells you something they heard, but that they themselves did not witness. Mohammed claims to tell what something called Allah said, but Mohammed was never with this Allah to hear this Allah speak. And there are a few typical Islamic reactions to this kind of factual threat to Islam. Islam must attack the Bible and claim, "The Bible is more hearsay than the Quran." Really, they cannot help it. Islam is as predictable as the sun rising. Number two, they must repeat the claim, "No, Allah spoke the Quran," which is akin to shouting at a foreigner to make them understand. Or three, they must change the claim, "No, Allah wrote the Quran." Comedy at its best. But it does open up the way to a question you must learn to ask. What does that mean? Learn to keep this question like a medicine for the illness of Islam. Apply it when you feel your brain fog with claims that make no sense. For example, Allah wrote the Quran. What does that mean? This is such a wonderful question because it opens up the door to the Socratic method to attack vapid assumptions, tales, and outright lies. What does it mean that Allah wrote the Quran? Did Allah take pen in hand and take time to write it all, word for word, in exactly the order and structure which we see today? Or did Allah actually dictate, word for word, to some angel scribe who wrote it in shorthand and then later tried to fill it back out? Or did Allah just say, "Quran be," and it was created all at once, like the way Islam claims Allah made the worlds? If that was the case, why then are there so many contradictions, errors, and abrogations in the Quran? Did Allah write the whole Quran before the first surah was ever whispered to Muhammad? And this is an interesting point because one of the claims of Muhammad in the Bible is Isaiah 29:12. Isaiah 29:12 says, "And the book is delivered to one who is not educated, saying, 'Read this, please,' and he says, 'I can't read.'" Islam's claim that this verse refers to Muhammad can only be made if they can state that the Quran was a whole book which existed and could be handed to Muhammad. Now, you Christians should latch on to this truth and never let go. And if you call yourself Muslim, I challenge you to think. Would it make sense to claim Muhammad is the person in Isaiah 29:12 and then claim the Quran was not ever a finished written book which could be handed to him? But this video is about hearsay, and specifically that the Quran is all hearsay. Now that you know the story of Islam, let's review the definition of hearsay and see whether the story of Islam fits the definition. Rumor, talk or opinion widely disseminated with no discernible source. Yes, Islam is all talk. Muhammad never worked a miracle to prove there was this imagined Allah. Widely disseminated? Certainly. 1.2 billion people repeat the gossip they have heard. No discernible source. Absolutely, no man has any way to discern if Allah, Jibril, or Muhammad was the source. Rumor, a statement or report without known authority for its truth. Yes, the Quran is a collection of statements over the 23 years of one man's lifetime. Without known authority. There is no endorsement from God, no miracles, no healings. Therefore, the authority is unknown. Muhammad attempts to claim credentials from the true known source of authority, the Torah and Bible. But his attempts must be viewed as failures and lies, because none of his claims can be supported with any facts. Hearsay evidence. Evidence based not on a witness's personal knowledge, but on another's statement not made under oath. Islam is not based on Muhammad's personal knowledge of what Allah may or may not have said, based on another's statement. In this case, the claim of an invisible angel that only Muhammad heard, not made under oath. No man heard, saw, or had any evidence this Jibril ever existed. Jibril was certainly not under oath. Hearsay, evidence that is offered by a witness, but rather their testimony is based on what others have said. The witness with no direct knowledge is Muhammad. He had no direct knowledge of this Allah originating the Quran. Muhammad's testimony is based on what he can only claim another, this Jibril, has said. Muhammad's so-called revelations absolutely fit, picture-perfect, the legal definition of hearsay. Muhammad's stories would be absolutely inadmissible in any actual court in the world, because Muhammad's tales would be viewed as complete, unsupportable hearsay. I think any viewer with an open, functioning mind can see and understand the problem which condemns Islam as a fraud based entirely on hearsay. Remember, hearsay is when someone tells you something they heard, but they themselves did not witness. So I have to ask you, how do you know that Allah wrote the Quran?
Allah told us he did.
That is wrong. Were you there, O Muslim? Did you hear Allah speak the Quran? If you claim you were, you are telling a lie. Muhammad did not hear Allah utter the Quran. Islam is nothing more than Muhammad telling us something he had no direct knowledge of. Think about that. Muhammad did not hear Allah utter the Quran. Muhammad did not see Allah write the Quran. Muhammad did not see Allah give the Quran to Jibril. In fact, no one ever even saw this so-called Jibril. No one ever heard this Allah speak or say, "Yes, I send the Quran." So based on the definition of hearsay, the entire story of Islam and the Quran is pure hearsay. But understand, Islam has had 1400 years to develop defenses against logic. In this case, their defense is obvious.
No, no, no! In Islam we have the Quran and we have the hadiths.
The Arabic word hadiths actually means hearsays. So we have the Quran and we have hearsays. So the Quran cannot be hearsay. Now, if this feels just like the story of the Mahdi killing the Islamic Antichrist, the Dajjal, so the Mahdi cannot be the Antichrist defined in the Bible, you are beginning to see the pattern in the subterfuge that Islam uses over and over. When the correct and easy observation is that Islam is clearly described by facts or biblical references, Satan's tactic has been to create a faux fulfillment and point away from the truth. So to create a smokescreen and hide the fact that the entire Quran is hearsay, Islam has created a whole science around a branch of Islam called the hearsays, or the Hadiths. You read that right. You can Google it. Islam, Hadith, science. With a whole branch of science dedicated to hearsays, they know that the Quran cannot be hearsay. Islam is the most cunning and well-woven quilt of lies imaginable, all from the mind of the father of lies. The entire Quran, Muhammad's whole story, is nothing more than hearsay. And therefore, I reject Islam forever. And I wholeheartedly, without fear of this imagined Allah, encourage you to do the same. Remember, hearsay is when someone tells you something they heard, but they themselves did not witness. Muhammad did not hear Allah utter the Quran. Muhammad did not see Allah write the Quran. Muhammad did not see Allah give the Quran to Jibril, if that is his real name. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.